Shoulder floor on the right side. This way, look, we know from that type of position that reverse lift incredibly dangerous. So you've got two styles here, one from standing position, incredibly good, one from part out, incredibly good. So it'll be very interesting to see how they deal with each other. First lift. Don't be sorry, you're going to have a good one. Good one. He's to his feet, has got those. Has got that arm trapped, he's trying to lock his hand. See, yes, he works his way out of that position. Personally thought it was a 2 points. The way you took it back, you can't give four because there was no back exposure really. But he did bring him from grounded position up, brought him over to the side. But I don't think the judges see it like this. I'm not too sure, maybe he knew his opponent, maybe studied that, so if he did go for that reverse lift, he could posture up and explore it out. We'll be interested to see how it works for him. Lose the challenge, makes the title up on 1-1 now, in favour. Maybe the challenge not exactly needed there, but probably better to save it for later in the fight when a more important decision needs to be made. Chasing it down, he doesn't quite get there.
just when the whole crowd factor you performs in front of an arena full of your family, your friends, and English wrestling fans as well. How aware of you, how aware are you of the noise of maybe individual things that people are even saying when you're in the crowd?
Well, it's strange because even if all these people are shouting, you don't really hear it. You're kind of like locked into the job in hand. You might hear, for example, someone that's very close to you. Like, I remember when I used to wrestle, even if there was 4,000 or 5,000 people shouting, I could always hear my dad in the crowd shouting certain things, and my coach, and all of that, I could hear, because you just kind of locked into the moment. So what happens outside, you don't really hear it until the match is over with, and then you start to hear everything again.
What time will that sound like? It's right over. It's gone.
He's now going for that reverse lift. This time, this is a knock him over for another total exposure. He's keeping down. Looking for the fall. Look for that reverse lift again if he can drive his hands underneath his opponent. Challenge going in from the Chinese coach there. He thinks he shouldn't have been given us the 2 points, as it was a slip throw. But the difference is, he went for the hip throw, and Ismael caught him, locked his hands on that body block, and then stopped the movement, and then dictated it further. As you can see here, locks his hands, then goes down with him, kind of catches him in the air in the moment. So here, stays on his feet, takes him down for the two, then here again, realizes his opponent tries to sit through his head, knocks him forward onto his back. And a leg foul, as you can see, he had hold of his knee pad there, which is obviously not allowed, especially in Greco-Roman. Had him down, the judge at the back did signal for a pin. So there's a lot of info to kind of work through in one challenge.
Conversation on the sidelines.
Of the challenge decision. This is a block from Red Jindal confirmed. 2 points from Red Norris. After it's a blocking action from Red, 2 points Red. And after here we have a leg fall by Blue. Giving up to Chip by Blue. Motion Blue, 2 points Red. And return in partial position.
I want to hear because Parterre is going to be the next phase of this. Just 2 points to the right. I promise I'll end up to finish this off.
He's ever so close now. Close to that Olympic spot, but you know you've got one turn left to go. It's such a bit of a hectic moment. Takes him over for two. That won't be it. Jumped over the top of him, got the exposure, taking 2 points.
Matches the result. Fanamantua is playing off.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the national competition.